you're a mapper and you've made like maps which have triggers and stuff, then you probably know that entities like trigger once are able to find their target entities by their name. Have you ever wondered how? Well, it's this. There, that's basically it. So this will find an entity with the name my underscore entity, starting from the first entity in the world, comparing its target name to the string we pass to it. Now, in case it doesn't find an entity, it just returns a null pointer, so we can easily check whether that entity exists or not. This first parameter, however, to which I pass null pointer, is the starting entity. So if it's null pointer, it's just gonna go from world spawn to the last entity in the map. However, we can do something with it. It allows us to write a loop that will basically go through all entities in the map of the same name. It would look something like this. This is more or less how all entities trigger their targets. If we take a look at trigger relay's use method, we'll see it calls subuse targets, and that eventually calls fire targets. Fire targets does a for loop, and well, it basically stops if it can't find any more entities with a given name. And you can already tell that this function was written quite early on in Half-Life's development. In my example, there was a while loop, and that's usually how you should do it. You should use the util functions instead of the legacy ones. Of course, there are other ways to find entities as well, for example by class name or by or within the radius of a sphere. Now, there is one little caveat when it comes to finding other entities by name and such. You should never really use these finding functions in spawn, unless you're 100% sure that the entity you're looking for is guaranteed to be available at that time. If you're using finding functions in the use method, or basically anywhere post-spawn, this is okay. But let's say you have an entity that has several pointers to other entities and you want to initialize these pointers once when the entity spawns, for some performance reasons I guess. Well, it's probably not gonna work because your entity will spawn before the entities it is meant to target. Remember that entities spawn sequentially, not all at once, so you would get null pointers, even if you placed those entities in the map and named them correctly. Now don't worry, there's a simple workaround. There is a method that gets executed after all entities have spawned. It's called activate. So if you want to find entities while they're being spawned, do it in activate. That's how func train does it. And I guess that's about it for finding other entities. Let's move on to string t now, and then we can write a new entity. If you look at the definition of string t, you'll see that it's an unsigned integer. What? How does one fit a string into an... Well, that's not what's going on. The engine basically has a string allocator, and inside of it, there's this huge buffer of strings. So you can think of string t as an index into that array of strings, if we can call it that way. So yeah, that's all the mystery behind it. I could go into the details, but I don't want to overcomplicate things. In order to actually allocate one such string, you gotta use the alloc string macro. Here's an example where you want to parse a string key value and store it into a variable. On the other hand, if you have a constant string, you can use make string instead of alloc string. And finally, if you want to get an actual C string out of these, you use the string macro. Now, let's write an entity... Yeah, sometimes I run out of ideas. Well, let's think of something very stupid and useless, like an entity that lets you explode every entity that matches a given name. The mapper would basically specify the name, trigger the entity, and every entity with the name would explode and disappear. Simple as that. Let's start with the key values. So first we're gonna have this thing called explode victim name. In the FGD, it's just gonna be explode underscore victim. And that's basically gonna be the name which this entity will find, you know, find all the entities with this name and then make them explode. Now I could have just used, you know, pev target for this, but for the sake of the tutorial, you know. Now you might also wanna save or store this key value. And finally, in use, we're gonna basically write this. Now if you want the entity to disappear, you might as well set the effects to if no draw and maybe solid to solid not. And that would basically make them explode and disappear. Alright, now let's see that in game. I think that's everything for this one. There's really not much to say about string T, finding other entities. It's a small pair of subjects. I do gotta say though, we're getting closer and closer to a new chapter, which is gonna include various utilities in the SDK like trace lines, which if you're coming from a modern engine are basically raycasts. So once that chapter is done, I suppose we can finally move on to weapons and stuff like that. So yeah, the future is indeed exciting. Until then, happy programming.